running is actually therapeutic for me. That was something I never would have been able to do. My name is Lisa Cardillo. I've been a teacher of advanced chemistry, AP biology for 7 years.
My name is Ragean Scott, and I work at Sanford USD Medical Center. When I went into the doctor, just for my routine physical for the year, my blood pressure was so high, her main concern was having a stroke.
2016 started out like a normal, typical school year. But then my closest childhood friend was diagnosed with breast cancer before we even turned 35. I worked at a school where there was a school shooting. And then my grandfather passed away and my husband's grandmother passed away. And so it was a series of really pretty significant losses for me in my life.
My weight began being a health concern when I was about 30 and I developed high blood pressure. And the doctor had to put me on meds, and the meds weren't even controlling it. I knew I had to do something. I had bariatric surgery in May of 2017. I have lost about 120 pounds, and I've been maintaining my weight now for over a year.
I had gastric bypass surgery in January of 2017. I lost a total of 160 pounds and I've kept it off for 2 years. I realized that life is way too short. I didn't want to live my life not being able to do the things that I wanted to do.
I knew that I was slowly gaining weight as the years went on. I would say I really noticed a most drastic weight gain after I had my second son.
I started having problems with my weight probably right when I started going to college, as I became like a stressed and emotional eater.
I did worry about not being around for my kids at a young age.
Before surgery, some life situations that made me uncomfortable would be getting on an airplane and having to ask for the seatbelt extender.
Going on an airplane and not being able to have the seatbelt buckle.
Going clothes shopping with my friends because I would have to go to a different section. I couldn't go to the same section as they could.
I'm Dr. Curtis Peery. I work for Sanford Health, Sioux Falls, South Dakota. I've been a surgeon for 18 years. I got into bariatric surgery because of the satisfaction that I see patients have with the results. I know I'm making a major impact in their health, and so I find that very satisfying.
Bariatric surgery is better known as weight loss surgery. This usually involves changing the size of your stomach and or bypassing a portion of the intestine. When you think of surgery, you might think of a large incision. However, most bariatric surgery is performed using a minimally invasive approach, either laparoscopic or robotic surgery. Both of these minimally invasive approaches are performed through a few small incisions. Laparoscopic bariatric surgery is performed with special long-handled tools that the surgeon operates while viewing magnified images from a camera on a video screen. In robotic bariatric surgery, the surgeon controls the Da Vinci system to perform the procedure. He or she uses small, precise instruments and sees the entire operation in 3D high definition.
I had thought about bariatric surgery over about 5 years.
I felt like bariatric surgery would be my best chance of losing the weight.
I thought I could do it on my own. Then I decided, you know, I need a solution to help me get the weight off.
I let myself go too far. I didn't think I could do it alone anymore.
Surgery itself doesn't fix anything for people, but if they really understand that it's a tool to use to have meaningful and successful weight loss, that's where we really see the great results.
I chose Dr. Peery because I liked him as a person.
He came in and he was very straightforward. He was like, this is what you need to do. This is why you would be a great candidate.
I didn't know a lot about robotic surgery and it intrigued me a lot.
Robotics is just a tool that enhances my ability to do those really sophisticated maneuvers because I have more capability. It doesn't mean the system's doing it for me. It doesn't make anything automated, but I'm able to use my skills that I was trained for extensively in the way I need to.
During my pre-op visit, I got a gastric bypass book.
They walked me through literally everything.
They gave me a 1,200 calorie diet.
The pros, the cons, things that I need to watch out for.
Videos to watch online.
Pitfalls that people have and how it really is a tool to help you in your life. It's not a end-all, be-all fix.
Successful surgery starts months before the surgery, in which the patient has really engaged us and has really been receptive to our plan of care. And so they've changed habits and they're prepared for surgery.
The pre-op changes that you make prior to bariatric surgery are really tough. You have to make the decision to eat healthy, to be active, and really make those lifestyle changes. My recovery after surgery was fairly easy.
The process after surgery was easy. Dr. Peery, the dietitian, and some other team members came in to check on me every couple hours, and I came home the next day.
I was off work for 2 weeks.
I went back to work, I want to say 2 weeks right after surgery.
Within a week, I was really feeling pretty good and getting back to my normal routine.
I knew I reached my weight loss goal when I was able to go to a store and buy a pair of pants without having to go to a different section.
I was able to go to my favorite store and not shop in the plus size.
I could sit in the airplane and not have the seatbelt extender and people, you know, saying, you look like a totally different person. You are half the person that you were before.
I stood in the fitting room and cried when I came out in jeans that I never thought I would ever be able to get into. That was a huge moment.
I was able to run my first half marathon. I never in a million years would have ever thought I could do anything like that. And so that was a pretty big moment for me.
I am no longer on high blood pressure medication. I'm just all around feeling better.
I am living my best life. I'm doing what I want to do. I decided to go back to school and get another degree, and I don't think I would have had the confidence in my body image to do that prior.
It has been amazing. I feel amazing since having this surgery.
Thinking about my journey and where I've come, the only thing that I wish I had done differently was do it earlier. I think life is too short, and I think that the more you can live life, the stronger your life is. And don't be hesitant. Get that support system and be ready to make those lifestyle changes and realize it's a tool. You've got to make those changes to allow the tool to be successful.